go to my tab
जी
list.
मैम, ओके okay.
it's getting recorded, so it's okay. Thank you.
ओके. अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीबॉडी, लेट एवरीबॉडी जॉइन एंड देन वी विल ऑफिशियली स्टार्ट द लेक्चर. So I think there are enough members, so we can just start. Okay, so I think there are around 13 members right now. So can you just tell me how many of you are new in today's class? Because I've been taking the last two classes in the last 2 days. So today is the last class for English, like we'll be having the next class from Monday now. So how many of you were here in the yesterday's class and on Monday? So just text in the chat box so that I can know that how many of you are new and how many of you have been attending my lectures for the last week also. So I'm waiting for your chat. Come on, just let me know that how many of you are new here, and then we'll officially begin. And let's wait for everybody to join, because I think there are more students who would want to join. In the yesterday's class, we did Prezi writing, and because since the paper is for Prezi and composition, so in the yesterday's class we did Prezi writing, and I gave you a homework, which I would be collecting in the next class, which is on Monday. Officially, and I would also present you the solution of the Prezi, which I gave you to do as your homework. So it is of paper 2004, I believe. I think yes, it's paper 2004. Dr. Aliab, can you confirm? Because I think I shared the link as well. Okay. There is Zara who's new. There's Tabish who's new. Okay. So rather than jumping straight to the topic, I would like to first of all introduce the paper to you and the topic to you as well. Because composition, see, we are doing Prezi and composition, the whole paper I'd be doing. So what I do is that I divide 2 days for Prezi and 1 day for comprehension. So in the future weeks, what I'd be doing is that I'd give 1 day each. For example, there's also a comprehensive note, which is exactly of the same marks of Prezi and comprehension, almost off and on, almost the same marks. So what I'd be doing is I'd be giving each day to each paper. So for example, one day on Monday we'd be doing Prezi, on the second day we'd be doing a comprehension or composition, or on the third day we'd be discussing about how to write the comprehensive note, so that officially we'd be doing all the three main questions along with the idiomatic phrases and synonyms and antonyms and everything that will be a part of it. So let me tell you what the paper is comprised of and how to attempt the composition paper, because I believe that first of all, English is your compulsory subject, and you need to focus on 2-3 very important things which are there in this paper. Obviously, English has two papers. One is essay writing and the other is this precedent composition. So first of all, how you have to deal with the preci comprehension paper. Number one is that first of all, you have to, because as we all know, this paper is more about to deal with your mind, to deal with your nerves, rather than to be very intelligent or to be very smart about the knowledge, right? Okay, fine. Everybody has the knowledge. Everybody goes there in the paper or attempts the paper with enough of the knowledge, and everybody goes there prepared. Then how would you differ from an intelligent student or a smart student? How does the paper differ? ठीक है, ये दो तीन चीजें आपने अपने दिमाग में बिठा लेनी हैं कि आपने जब आपको पेपर मिलेगा, you don't have to shake or lack confidence at all. You don't have to get panic. आपने बिल्कुल भी panic नहीं होना. जी. अच्छा, आपने बिल्कुल भी panic नहीं होना, because it's more about the paper of how good you deal with the exam, because you know it's about how smart your paper is. देखिए, exactly as your previous teacher was also telling you, सत्य सवर की बात भी मैं सुन रही थी, वो भी यही कह रहे थे कि हमने कोई एग्जाम के अंदर कोई थेरीज नहीं लिखने बैठ जाना, या हमने ये नहीं बताना उनको कि what are we capable of. ठीक है, हमने उनको ये बताना है कि how well we know about the exam and what are the tricks which we can use to attempt the paper in a better way, and how well we can attempt the paper, and how good our paper eventually at the end looks, and is the examiner impressed from the paper. Because I told you ki ji aapki writing, aapki ye sari cheeze ek had tak count karti hain, theek hai, but it doesn't mean ki agar aapki writing achhi nahi hai to aap paper pass nahi kar sakte. I mean, no, not at all. ठीक है, ये सारे मिथ्स हैं और कुछ ऐसी चीज़ें हैं. आप येस यू राइट नीट, इफ़ यू आर वेरी डर्टी राइटिंग, डजेंट मैटर. आप थोड़ा खुला खुला करके लिखें, वर्ड्स के अंदर थोड़ी सी स्पेस दें, एंड यू विल बी फाइन. आई मीन योर पेपर शुड लुक फाइन, दैट्स इट. इट डजेंट मीन, बिकॉज नॉर्मली डॉक्टर्स आर अटेम्प्टिंग द एग्जाम, और उनका एग्जाम में अक्सर उनकी राइटिंग थोड़ी सी ऐसी होती है जो नहीं पढ़ी जाती, बट इट डजेंट मीन दैट दे कांट अटेम्प्ट द पेपर और दे विल फेल द पेपर. नो, ऐसी बात नहीं है. खैर, कॉम्पोजिशन के पेपर की तरफ आते हैं. मैं थोड़ा सा आपको बता दूं कि जी कॉम्पोजिशन का पेपर दिखा भी देती हूँ, सैम्पल पेपर के होता क्या है और कैसे आपने पेपर को करना है और किस तरह से. मैं आपको थोड़ा सा पहले पेपर दिखा दूं कि जी कॉम्पोजिशन का पेपर आपको जो बेसिकली आज पेपर मैंने सॉल्व कराना है वो कैसा है, और उसके अंदर कौन सा उन्होंने पैसेज दिया हुआ है जो आपने सॉल्व करना है. Let me share the screen with you. Okay, just a minute. Yes, we'd be doing the paper of 2000, and I have two. I have paper of 2004 and paper of 2005, both. So we'd be doing paper of 2005. Yes, 2005 का हम करेंगे comprehension passage, क्योंकि आज हमने comprehension पे ही करना है. कुछ चीजें मैं आपको साथ साथ ही बताती जाऊंगी कि कौन सी चीजें important हैं और कैसे उनको करना है और कैसे उनको tackle नहीं करना, और कौन सी चीजों को आपने ज्यादा importance देनी है और कौन सी चीजों की weightage ज्यादा होती है. ठीक है, कल हमने किया था कल हमने प्रेसिक का जो पैसेज किया था वो भी हमने 2005 के पेपर में से किया था, साइकोसिस एंड न्यूरोसिस के ऊपर, और आज हम उसी का ही कॉम्प्रिहेंशन करेंगे. कैन यू सी द स्क्रीन मूविंग? आई हैव शेयर्ड इट. नो, ओके, लेट मी सी व्हाट्स द प्रॉब्लम. अच्छा जी, आई एम ट्राइंग टू share the screen. Yes, it's here. Okay, so we have this paper. I hope now you can see. Is my screen visible to you all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Okay, good. So for the students who are new today, are new here, I would want you all to, I would want you all to just have a look at how does the paper look like, first of all. Okay, and today we have this paper, so we take that comprehension passage and I would tell you, along with the passage, that how you have to solve the passage. हमने लास्ट टाइम भी एक पैसेज किया था. मैंने ओल्ड स्टूडेंट्स को पता होगा कि मैंने उनको कुछ टिप्स एंड ट्रिक्स भी बताई थी और कुछ उनको मैंने कहा भी था कि वो खुद से सॉल्व करने की कोशिश करें इफ दे वर एबल टू. एंड सम ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स आल्सो सेंड मी देयर होमवर्क. बट टुडे कैन यू प्लीज म्यूट योर माइक्स. कैन यू म्यूट योर माइक्स एवरीबॉडी. Okay. So, yes, see, this is the first thing which is there in the paper. The very first question is that make a precis of the given passage. So you have this for 25 marks, 20 plus 5. And then the next is question number 2, which is the basically the comprehension passage, because it has 5 questions with it, right? And you're supposed to answer the questions, okay? इस तरह का आपको एक कॉम्प्रिहेंशन पैसेज आएगा जो कि इट इज इटसेल्फ इज आई थिंक 20 मार्क्स अगेन. देन यू हैव अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव नोट. इस कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव नोट की मैं बात करी थी. आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस नोट. सो वी बी डूइंग फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट वीक ऑनवर्ड्स. आई वाज थिंकिंग टू डिवाइड द क्लासेस इन दिस वे दैट वन डे वी आर गोइंग टू गिव टू प्रेसी, वन डे वी आर गोइंग टू गिव टू कॉम्प्रिहेंशन, एंड द थर्ड डे वी आर गोइंग टू गिव टू कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव नोट. बिकॉज आई बिलीव दैट ऑल दीज थ्री थिंग्स शुड बी गिवन इक्वल इंपॉर्टेंस, बिकॉज ऑल दीज थ्री थिंग्स हैव इक्वल मार्क्स, राइट? दे आर डिवाइडेड इनटू इक्वल मार्क्स. क्योंकि देखिए, it's not about one thing. Yes, Preci is the most important question, yes, because and it's the most difficult question as well in the paper, but we should give the importance to all the papers, all the questions altogether, because I believe that once you give the importance to Preci, because initially we gave importance to Preci in the first 1 week, and in the second week also we gave 2 days to precis. Why? Because it's the most important question, and once you are in flow with your preci, you would be doing your note, comprehensive note, in a very good manner, because preci is the basic, is the root of the paper. आपको अगर प्रेसी अटेम्प्ट करनी आ जाएगी तो कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव नोट इज नथिंग फॉर यू, बिकॉज इट्स फॉर 250 टू 300 वर्ड्स ओनली. But it's not about the words, it's about the quality of your language, what you are writing in the language. Because Preci ke andar jitna aapne Preci ko simple karna hai na, jitna aapne Preci ki language ko simple karke likhna hai, utna hi comprehensive note mein aapne vocabulary zyada use karni hai aur language utni aapne difficult use karni hai, so that the examiner knows that you people know how to tackle your question. And I believe that aapke paas 250 to 300 words hain, which are not very much if you know how to write proper English. Isliye humne Preci se start kiya hai na, so that we can at least bring you on the track. And once you're on the track, then I think nobody can retrack you, because then you'd be going on. I believe then you would not need any other aid once you're on the track. And I believe practice makes a man perfect, and you need to keep practicing in order to, you know, do well in your exam. Because Preci is a maths question, as I told you. Comprehension is also about practicing. कॉम्पोजिशन के पेपर में आपने जब तक प्रैक्टिस नहीं करनी, आप पेपर पास नहीं कर सकते. ऐसे में तो आपने क्वालिटी लिखनी होती है ना, दैट इज समथिंग एल्स. इट्स ऑल अबाउट इन्फॉर्मेशन, हाउ अलर्ट यू आर इन योर करंट अफेयर्स, हाउ वेल यू नो अबाउट द फैक्ट्स एंड फिगर्स. बट हियर इन प्रेसी एंड कॉम्प्रिहेंशन और कॉम्पोजिशन पेपर, यू जस्ट हैव टू practice English, because without practicing, you just even don't think to go for attempting the paper, because it's not about how good you are in English or how well you know about English or how well you know English or how good your tense is, your grammar is. No, it's not about it. It's about how better and how well you know how to attempt the paper, basically. And attempting the paper is an art, right? If you know how to attempt the paper and how to manage your time and how to divide your time in a good manner, definitely you would be able to divide your time, you manage your time and do well in the exam, inshallah. Okay, so we are seeing that this is a comprehensive note, and then you have a lot of idioms and narrations and from indirect to direct, then you have synonyms, antonyms, and a lot of other things. We'd be practicing these things as well, but I'm not just pushing you right away to these things first, because I need to correct your Prezi first, because Prezi is difficult, and once you know how to attempt it and once you are in a habit of practicing it, then these questions have no worth. I mean, they are very easy in front of Prezi. Anyhow, we'd be starting with a little bit about how to attempt the comprehension. And I'd straight away start with the comprehension so that I can tell you about the tricks one by one along with reading the passage. Kyunki kuch thode se bachche I can see who are new over here. Most of you are old, so I would not waste your time. I would just right away start with the 2005 past paper. Can you see the screens, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you see this PowerPoint presentation?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, it's like, first of all, okay, let me see, somebody's written something in the chat box. Okay, what does it say? Okay. Yes. So, okay. Now, can you see these slides? My father loved all instruments. Are we all on the same slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Acha. Somebody would like to read, or I shall read? Would anybody want to read? Or I shall read? बिल्कुल खामोशी हो गई है. बस रीडिंग के बारे में सब चुप करके बैठ जाते हैं. एंड आई डोंट नो कि आप लोग पता नहीं मेरी रीडिंग भी सुन रहे होते हैं कि नहीं. बिकॉज द थिंग इज दैट यू हैव टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट. आई एक्चुअली मेक यू पीपल रीड सो दैट यू नो यू कॉन्सेंट्रेट वेन यू रीड. सो वेन आई एम रीडिंग ऑब्वियसली आई एम कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग, बट आई डोंट नो इफ यू पीपल आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग और नॉट. एनी हाउ आई वुड वॉन्ट टू यू ऑल टू लिसन टू मी वेरी अटेंटिवली, बिकॉज कॉम्प्रिहेंशन इज ऑल अबाउट अंडरस्टैंडिंग द कॉम्प्रिहेंशन. एंड आफ्टर रीडिंग द कॉम्प्रिहेंशन आई वुड वॉन्ट यू पीपल टू आंसर माई क्वेश्चन और टू जस्ट टेल मी वट इज द थीम ऑफ द ऑफ दिस composition and how do you feel after reading the composition. So once I finish the reading, I want you people to answer my questions. Okay, so I'm reading. This is the passage I've taken from past papers of CSS, so 2005, right? My father loved all instruments that would instruct and fascinate. His place to keep things was the drawer in the library table, where lying on top of his folder map was a telescope with brass extensions to find the moon and the big dripper after supper in our front yard, and to keep appointments with eclipses. In the back of the drawer, just a minute, there is somebody who's waiting. Okay. In the back of the drawer, you could find a magnifying glass, a kaleidoscope, and a... Just a minute, the students are joining in very late. Okay, I hope everybody has joined. Okay, sorry for. Okay, I'll just read from the top again. My father loved all instruments that would instruct and fascinate. His place to keep things was the drawer in the library table, where lying on top of his folder map was a telescope with brass extensions to find the moon and the big dripper after supper in our front yard, and to keep appointments with eclipses. In the back of the drawer, you could find a magnifying glass, a kaleidoscope, and a gyroscope, kept in the black buckram box, which he would set dancing for us on a string pulled tight. He had also supplied himself with an assortment of puzzles composed of metal rings and intersecting links and keys chained together, impossible for the rest of us. However, patiently shown to take part, he had an almost childlike love of the ingenious. In time, a barometer was added to our dining room wall, but we didn't really need it. My father had the country boy's accurate knowledge of the weather and its skies. He went out and stood on our front steps first thing in the morning and took a good look at it and a sniff. He was a pretty good weather prophet. He told us children what to do if we were lost in a strange country. Look for where the sky is brightest along the horizon, he said. That reflects the nearest river. Strike out for a river and you will find habitation. Eventualities were much on his mind. In his care for us children, he cautioned us to take measures against such things as being struck by lightning. He drew us all away from the windows during the severe electrical storms that are common where we live. My mother stood apart, scoffing at caution as a character failing. So I developed a strong meteorological sensibility. In years ahead, when I wrote stories, atmosphere took its influential role from the start. Commotion in the weather and the inner feelings aroused by such a hovering disturbance emerged connected in dramatic form. Yes. What is the passage about? And how does it feel to listen to the passage? Yes. I'm telling you, I will explain you the passage. I will tell you about what the passage is. I will answer the questions, but I would want you people to speak more than I speak, because if I speak more, I fear that you people are not listening, or maybe you people are not understanding, maybe you people are not following. So English ki jo class hoti, it's a very interactive session. So I would want you people to ask me things, to tell me what you felt about the passage. What is the passage about? कल जो स्टूडेंट्स थे क्लास के अंदर, उन्होंने नोटिस किया है कि प्रेसी किस तरह की थी, क्योंकि हमने कल 2005 के पेपर में से प्रेसी के, मैंने आपको दिखाया भी है पेपर, आपने देखा है कि प्रेसी कैसी थी, और आपको कॉम्पोजिशन का पैसेज कैसा आया है. आई मीन हाउ डिफरेंट द पैसेजेस आर. I told you that the examiner always balances his paper. So what it does is that if he gives a difficult passage of प्रेसी, he gives an easier passage of composition. Sometimes he gives a very difficult passage of composition and he gives an easier passage of pressing. Sometimes he give both passages, not very difficult passages, but just he gives sort of, I would say, sometimes very easy. Both passages are easy, but they have something within them, which is, I believe, you have to, put a little strain on your mind in order to solve those passages. ऐसा नहीं हो सकता कि जी वो बिल्कुल सोचे बगैर या सोचे समझे बगैर सॉल्व किए जाने वाले पैसेजेस हों. That's not at all possible. Anyhow, you people are supposed to tell me that how does the passage look like?
This passage is about interests of father in atmosphere readings and its impact on the children.
Who's speaking? Can you tell me your name? Sorry, I can't see your name over here.
Ma'am, I'm Aliab.
Okay, Aliab. Okay. So, okay, how many of you were here in yesterday's class? So can you compare both the things that how, you know, what is the difficulty level of both the things if you see Pressy and if you see a composition passage? Yes, Aliab, you're right. It's about father's interest in the weather, father's interest in reading different things about the weather and about and how things change and how he senses those changes. And obviously wherever they are living, they are very close to the nature and they can see that everything over there is so close to the nature, the sky, and they see everything, the changes that and they're obviously the storms are there, so the winds are there, the pressures are there, the air pressure is there, so they can obviously sense everything. So who is the writer of the passage ka writer kaun hai? Is passage maine bhi aapke samne padha, iska writer kaun hai? Okay, somebody is saying writer is remembering his childhood memories of his father and relationship of his father regarding astrological knowledge. Okay, yes. It's about the knowledge from the skies. Yes. Tell me, who is the writer of the passage?
आप
प्लीज आप लोग अपने अपने जो माइक्रोफोन्स हैं ना उनको म्यूट कर दें, सिर्फ वो बोले जब आपने बोलना हो तब आप अनम्यूट करके बोलें, दैट्स इट. अदरवाइज एवरीबॉडी प्लीज कीप योर माइक्स म्यूट बिकॉज़ दैट क्रिएट्स अ लॉट ऑफ डिस्टॉर्शन. यस अलिया, यू वर सेइंग समथिंग.
मैम इज आइदर द डॉटर और सन हु इज राइटिंग दिस.
Yes, exactly. Okay, I would want to share my experience that this passage, I've read it somewhere, I think in my master's, I've read this passage. It's from, the writer is basically a female who's writing, it's his daughter who's writing the passage. And or iska na mujhe ab exactly, I don't remember the name of the writer, but I have read this. Kyunki jab main ye padh rahi thi, to I felt that I read this story somewhere. So then I felt that yes, it was somewhere in my master's. Ye master's ki unhone book mein se, literature ki book mein se utha ke aapko ye di diye. Theek hai? And it's a very famous story. It's from essays of some famous writer, aur un essays, literature ke essays mein se utha ke unhone aapko language ke paper ke andar di diye. So I have seen ke jo composition ka paper hai na, usme jo ये जो आता है आपको कॉम्प्रिहेंशन, वो लिटरेचर में से होता है ज्यादातर. उसका जो जो कंटेंट होता है ना, वो लिटरेचर में से उठा के देते हैं मोस्टली. और क्योंकि अभी मैं 2004 वाला भी पढ़ रही थी, वो भी लिटरेचर का ही शेले का ऐसे है, उसमें से उसने उठा के उसका कंटेंट दिया हुआ है. प्रेसी जो है वो डिफरेंट जगहों में से दे देते हैं, डिफरेंट अफेयर, करंट अफेयर में से दे देता है, पोलिटिकल साइंस में से वो दे देता है राइटर, एग्जामिनर हु सेट्स द पेपर. बट जो कॉम्पोजिशन वाला है ना, वो ज्यादातर जो है ना वो लिटरेचर में से उठा के देते हैं, क्योंकि नॉर्मली द पीपल हु आर सेटिंग द पेपर बिलोंग टू दिस बैकग्राउंड, लिटरेचर बैकग्राउंड. तो उन्होंने कोई ना कोई चीज लिटरेचर की तो आपको देनी ही होती है. जरूरी नहीं है कि वो, क्योंकि एक पेपर सेटर तो नहीं है ना, मल्टीपल पेपर सेटर्स बैठे, तो वहां पर लिटरेचर का जरूर कोई ना कोई पेपर सेटर बैठा है जो कि आपको लिटरेचर का पेपर डाल रहा है अंदर, तो लिटरेचर का मटीरियल उसमें जरूर होगा. तो नॉर्मली कॉम्प्रिहेंशन जो है ना वो लिटरेचर का होता है. और जो इसके अंदर एक और चीज है ना, जो कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव नोट है, वो भी नॉर्मली लिटरेचर में से ही उन्होंने ईडीएम्स और इस तरह की चीजें दी होती है, जो कि दे आर समवेयर फ्रॉम द लिटरेचर. उनका कुछ बैकग्राउंड लिटरेचर से मिलता जरूर होता है, ठीक है? तो वो उन्होंने कुछ ना कुछ उठा के जरूर दिया होता है. ओके, समबडी एल्स टेल मी व्हाट इज द पैसेज सेइंग, फिर हम इसके क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स करते हैं. मैं आपको बताती हूँ इसके क्वेश्चन किस तरह के दिए हुए और क्या उनके एक्सपेक्टेड आंसर्स हैं. जी, who wants to say something?
मैम.
जी
मैम, पहले तो वो बताता है कि मेरे डैड के पास डिफरेंट टाइप के इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स हैं. फिर वो इस पैसेज में बता रहा है कि मेरे डैड को बहुत सारी नॉलेज भी है अबाउट स्काई एंड कि अगर कभी खो जाए तो रास्ता कैसे स्टार्स से दिख दिख के ढूंढना है, इस टाइप की नॉलेज भी
हाँ
है।
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल ठीक है ओके यस दीज आर द थिंग्स विच ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट दीज थिंग्स एंड फॉर इंस्टेंस द वर्ड्स दे हैव अंडरलाइंड ठीक है ये जो मैंने वर्ड्स आपके लिए ये जो अंडरलाइन किए हुए ये पैसेज के अंदर ही अंडरलाइन हुए हुए थे पहले से ही और कुछ डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स का जो मीनिंग है वो मैंने नीचे लिखा है जो कि आप देख सकते हैं एट द बॉटम ठीक है इफ़ यू हैव एनी डिफिकल्टी जैसे इन जेन्युइन मीन्स ओरिजिनल इवेंचुअलिटीज आर द पॉसिबिलिटीज स्कफिंग इज टू मॉक व्हेन इज व्हेन हर मदर वाज स्कफिंग कमोशन इज अनरेस्ट एंड होवरिंग इज फ्लोटिंग ठीक है और ये जो बाकी सारे जो बोल्ड के अंदर मैंने वर्ड्स अंडरलाइन किए हुए हैं ये पेपर के अंदर ऐसे ही अंडरलाइन हुए हुए आए थे और इनके ऊपर एक उसने क्वेश्चन भी दिया हुआ है इन अंडरलाइंड फ्रेजेस और इन अंडरलाइंड वर्ड्स के ऊपर ठीक है लेट्स मूव टूवर्ड्स द क्वेश्चंस मैं आपको थोड़ा सा बता दूं कि किस तरह के क्वेश्चंस पेपर के अंदर जो पैसेज से रिलेटेड आपको आएंगे और आपने अच्छा आपने इस तरह करना है जिस तरह से मैंने एक दफा पैसेज पढ़ा ठीक है अगर आपको समझ आई आपको 10% समझ आई आपको 20% समझ आई आपको 30% समझ आई डजंट मैटर रीड द पैसेज अगेन डोंट गो एंड रीड द क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर्स फर्स्ट ये हम लोगों की बहुत बुरी आई हैव सीन द स्टूडेंट्स वेरी वेरी बैड हैबिट व्हाट दे डू इज स्ट्रेट अवे गो द क्वेश्चंस रीड द क्वेश्चंस एंड देन स्टार्ट फाइंडिंग द आंसर्स यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू डू दैट कम ऑन दिस दिस पेपर इज नॉट यू नो पेपर ऑफ योर मे बी मेट्रिकुलेशन और मे बी योर इंटरमीडिएट दिस इज बिगेस्ट एग्जाम ऑफ योर लाइफ राइट सो यू हैव टू एक्ट वेरी वाइजली इन दिस पेपर What you do is that you first of all read the comprehension passage very keenly, very deeply, and very you have to just see that you have make sure your concentration is not divided anywhere. You are properly reading the passage with full concentration. ठीक है आपने पहले उसको बहुत अच्छे गौर से पढ़ना है once, then you read it twice. Make sure that you're reading the passage again before reading the questions. Please make sure you're not going to jump towards reading the questions. Yes, now you can see the questions after reading it twice. Aap questions dekhe, sare padhe, achhi tarah padhe. Then come back. Then most 70% of the questions will be answered. Baghair dekhe hue aap unko you will be able to answer those 70% of the questions even without looking at the passage because you have read it twice and you have read it with your full concentration to aapko to problem hi nahi honi chahiye answers dhoondne mein aapko usi time pata chal jayega iska ye answer iska ye answer iska ye answer that is what we want you to know aapko khud hi se pata hona chahiye ki ye iska answer hai acha 70% to I am for sure aapko pata chal jayega jo 30% reh jayega na wo jab aap third time usko padhenge to aapko 30% tab mil jayega Number one. Number two, you're not going to pick up the lines and write them in your answer like this. You are going to explain the answer or write the answer in your own words. That's it. Number one. Number two is that if you get a question and you are asked something about anything from the passage, make sure you are direct and you have to answer to the point. Aapne ये इस चक्कर में नहीं पढ़ना कि आप लंबा आंसर करने के लिए आप कहानियां लिखने बैठ जाएं पेपर के अंदर नो बी ब्रीफ एंड बी टू द पॉइंट दैट इज व्हाट योर एग्जामिनर वांट्स यू टू डू यू आर अ मैच्योर स्टूडेंट यू आर टेकिंग अ सीएसएस अटेम्प्ट इट्स नॉट अ जोक आई मस्ट से इट्स नॉट अ जोक सो बी वेरी फोकस्ड राइट लेस एंड Write to the point and just write and focus on the quality of the passage and just focus on the main idea and be vigilant and be concentrated. Okay, this passage. Ubaid is saying this passage is written about the father, written by one of his children. As father seems to be okay. Spellings are all okay. ठीक है मेट्रोलॉजिस्ट बाई प्रोफेशन वो इज हैविंग मच इक्विपमेंट अबाउट नोइंग वेदर कंडीशंस And he knows how to protect his children from extreme weather patterns through his skills and interest in knowing nature. Okay, yes. You're close, Ubaid. You're close. You've understood it in a right way. And yes, there are obviously a lot of important things in the passage. ठीक है तो मैंने आपको पैसेज पढ़ के बता दिया आपको उसको थोड़ा एक्सप्लेन भी कर दिया द पैसेज इज बेसिकली अबाउट अ पर्सन हु इज एक्सट्रीमली इंटरेस्टेड इन रीडिंग वेदर हु इज एक्सट्रीमली इंटरेस्टेड इन व्हाट इज हैपनिंग ऑन द स्काई ही इज एक्सट्रीमली इंटरेस्टेड इन इक्लिप्सिस ही नोज हाउ टू यूज द टेलीस्कोप ही नोज हाउ टू कीप where to keep the telescope in order to see the moon and to see the eclipses, number one. Number two, when he says about kaleidoscope, it is an instrument which an instrument which has some mirrors in it, and when light is reflected through those instruments, there's some reflection which is formed, okay? And there are different colored patterns which are formed. So you sort of estimate what the weather is going to be, for example, theek hai? Yeah, what is the current condition on the skies? So which he would, he actually does it, and he makes it quite entertaining for his children, theek hai? So that his children also enjoy that. Then he says about assortment of puzzles, theek hai? That's how puzzles, you arrange the puzzles, that's about the, she is talking about the games. And then he's talking about barometer, which was added in the dining room. Basically, a barometer is also an instrument which measures the air pressure. Okay, and then just a minute, there is somebody who's waiting. Okay, I'll allow him. Okay, then yes. Okay, so when she says that my father had the country boy's accurate knowledge of the weather and its skies, so it means that her father has this knowledge and he is quite a good weather reader and he knows where to start with. Okay, so what first thing what he does in the morning is he takes a look at the weather first and sniffs it. What do you mean by sniffs it? What do you mean by sniffs the weather or sniffs the morning? How can you sniff the weather? I mean, what is it? What is sniffing?
Ma'am, sniff matlab sunghna nahi hota.
Exactly, exactly. So it is obviously it is to smell, right? But how does he sniff the weather, or how does he takes a look and then he sniffs it? I mean, what does this mean? So experience air by moving outside to predict about the weather, how will it be? Yes, and he, what he does is that...
To gaze the weather.
Basically, gazing is to look at the weather. Okay, gazing is to look. ठीक है यहाँ पे जो इसका लिटरल मीनिंग बन रहा है ना वो ठीक है वो टू लुक एट द वेदर ही बन रहा है या टू गेज एट द वेदर ही बन रहा है तो व्हाट ही डज इज ही सीज हाउ द मॉर्निंग लुक्स एंड देन ही स्निफ्स इट मतलब ही प्रिडिक्ट्स कि हाउ विल द डे गो ऑन एंड व्हाट विल बी द वेदर इन द एंटायर डे ही जस्ट स्निफ्स दैट वो सुबह होते ही जब वो देखता है ना हिज फर्स्ट लुक एट द मॉर्निंग वो जब जैसे आसमान को देखता है ना तो उसको समझ आ जाती है कि आज पूरे दिन में फॉर एग्जाम्पल मौसम कैसा रहेगा या उसको उसी टाइम पता चल जाता है कि जी मौसम जो है वो किस तरह से बदलेगा या वो बदलने वाला है ठीक है स्निफ्स इट बिकॉज़ ही इज अ वेदर रीडर सो ही गेट्स टू नो अच्छा ही वाज अ गुड व्हेन देन ही देन इट सेज ही वाज अ प्रीटी गुड वेदर प्रॉफिट ठीक है सो इट मीन्स दैट ही कैन रीड इट वेरी गुड सो ही टोल्ड अस चिल्ड्रन व्हाट टू डू इफ We were lost in a strange country. Look for where the sky is brightest along the horizon, he said. That reflects the nearest river. So obviously the essay, when it was written, this has been written in very old age and there were no cell phones and no electronics and gadgets so that you know you can tell where you are. So and there were no even there were no clocks to see the time. To kya hota tha ji, लोग आसमान को देख के टाइम का अंदाजा लगाते थे, लोग आसमान को देख के नमाज का टाइम बताते थे कि जी इस टाइम पे नमाज होने वाली है या ये टाइम है, अभी इस टाइम पे सुबह है या इस टाइम पे शाम है. तो वो आसमान को देख के ही लोग प्रिडिक्ट करते थे पुराने जमाने में, बिकॉज देयर वर नो क्लॉक्स एंड नथिंग. सारी इन्वेंशंस बाद में हुई हैं. तो फिर क्या होता था कि जी इस तरह से इफ समबडी यू नो बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली There were no maps, there were no tracks. तो क्या होता था कि जी जब कोई अगर गुम जाए तो उसको वो आसमान को देखता था और वहाँ पे जहाँ पे सबसे ज़्यादा ब्राइटनेस ज़्यादा होगी अलॉन्ग द होराइजन, मतलब आसमान के ऊपर जहाँ पे सबसे ब्राइटनेस ज़्यादा होगी, वो जगह जो है वो सबसे ज़्यादा जो है ना वो उसके करीब पानी होगा, रिवर. एंड रिवर रिवर्स एंड वाटर वॉज द सर्वाइवर एट दैट टाइम. लोग पानी के करीब रहते थे और लोग पानी के करीब ही जब गुम जाते थे या किसी जंगल में या किसी फॉरेस्ट में, व्हेन पीपल यूज टू गो एंड दे यूज टू गेट लॉस्ट, तो सबसे पहले वो आसमान को देख के सबसे पहले वो पानी ढूंढते थे, बिकॉज वाटर वॉज द मेन सर्वाइवर. क्योंकि उसमें फिश होती है, उसमें एडिबल्स होते हैं, उसमें रॉ फिश, दे यूज टू टेक इट आउट एंड दे यूज टू कुक इट ऑन द फायर एंड ईट इट. ठीक है, तो इस तरह करके ये पुराने जमाने में इस तरह से चीजें होती थी. दैट्स व्हाई यूज टू से strike out for a river and you will find habitation. This is what I just told you. Habitation is where you live, your habitat. तो जहाँ पे आपको पानी नजर आए वहाँ पे आपका survival है, वहाँ पे आप रहना शुरू हो जाते हैं. Eventualities were much on his mind. There were many possibilities. He drew us all away from the windows during the severe electrical storms that are common where we live. ठीक है, तो obviously जब कोई ना कोई तेज किस्म की या बहुत ज़्यादा कोई जिस तरह बिजली बहुत ज़्यादा आसमान के ऊपर गरज रही होती है या फिर आपकी बहुत ज़्यादा तेज हवा चल रही होती है, तो he used to take his children away from the windows ताकि वो इससे बच सकें या फिर obviously they don't have a bad impact on them. My mother stood apart scuffing at caution as a character failing, so I developed a strong meteorological sensibility. तो वहाँ से उसके अंदर you know children are very keen observers. I mean they observe things very keenly. बच्चे के जो mind के ऊपर बचपन के अंदर impact पड़ जाता है वो पूरी जिंदगी उसके पूरी जिंदगी उसकी life में वो आता रहता है. And it doesn't go away. You know when a child is very small and very young, if he sees something bad in his childhood, he doesn't forget it. Even when he grows up, when he becomes an adult, he doesn't forget it. And there are a few incidents which children remember. You know, there are some very bad incidents or very good incidents which children remember even when they grow up. So this is very important. So if you see your parents doing something in since your childhood, you're going to adopt it. And that impact of that particular thing which is laid on your character, on your personality, that will not go away in your entire life. 5 saal tak bacche ki life pe jo bhi impact ek dafa pad jata hai na, matlab 5 saal tak jo language wo learn kar leta hai, jo cheeze wo dekh leta hai, he doesn't forget those. Wo cheeze uski personality ke andar baith jati hai. Aur phir 5 saal ke baad jo cheeze wo observe karta hai ya wo jis environment mein rehta hai usko wo bahut jaldi aur bahut zyada अच्छी तरह से अडॉप्ट करता है. एंड व्हेन ही अडॉप्ट्स इट ही डजंट फॉरगेट इट. सो दिस हैपेंड विद द राइटर. उसने अपने बाप को ऑब्जर्व किया, उसने देखा कि उनके घर में तो ये कल्चर है. ठीक है, वेदर रीडिंग इज अ कल्चर, हैज बिकम अ कल्चर एंड डॉटर्स फॉलो देयर फादर्स अ लॉट. ठीक है, एंड चिल्ड्रन फॉलो देयर फादर्स अ लॉट. They fathers are the ideal. तो जब देखते हैं कि जी उनके फादर्स व्हाट आर दे डूइंग, what interests do they have, they sort of start adopting that mentality. And that mentality or that thinking and that things actually set in their mind, they're fixed in their mind somewhere in their unconscious, they are laid. चाहे आप चाहें या आप ना चाहें, आपके बच्चे के दिमाग में वो चीज़ बैठ जाएगी, जैसे कि राइटर के दिमाग में ये बैठ गया था कि हाउ इम्पॉर्टेंट द वेदर इज, बिकॉज हर फादर वॉज ऑल द टाइम डूइंग दिस, वॉज ऑल द टाइम रीडिंग द स्काइज एंड रीडिंग द थिंग्स, एंड दे हैड क्रिएटेड एन एनवायरमेंट एट देयर होम विच वॉज लाइक दिस, यू नो, व्हेन दे वर adding barometers in their dining rooms and they are bringing, you know, things, and when his father is fitting kaleidoscopes and fitting things, you know, of his own interest, so the children were actually becoming like that. To uske mind mein ye cheez baith gayi, and then when she wrote, she became a writer, and when she wrote different essays and different writings or poetry, everything had an impact of that weather and atmosphere, क्योंकि वो उसकी personality के अंदर चीज बैठ गई हुई थी, और जब वो लिखती थी कोई भी चीज तो वो it came out. ठीक है, for example, कुछ incidents ऐसे होते हैं आपकी life में जब आप बचपन में if you go through those incidents in a way that you see them very close to you, तो वो आपके अंदर बैठ जाते हैं और आपको पता भी नहीं चलता, and they become a part of your personality. And you don't know, sometimes some people are very aggressive, some people are very short-tempered, some people are very angry. So in their personality, something like that has happened, which is why they become that. They turn out to be that. Anyhow, this is what she's saying. Actually, she's in commotion in the weather and the inner feelings aroused. But such a hovering disturbance emerged, connected in a dramatic form. तो वो कह रही है कि जब इस तरह की कोई चीज होती थी, कोई स्ट्रॉम आती थी या कुछ इस तरह का होता था, तो उसकी जो इनर फीलिंग्स हैं, they used to get aroused, they used to get, they used to wake up actually. All the inner emotions, all the dead emotions and feelings, you know, of that time, of the time of her childhood, used to awaken, and she used to, you know, get back into that time, or phir us time pe likhti thi. Theek hai, this is what the writer is trying to say, and she reveals her feelings at the end of the passage. Theek hai, jo questions ki taraf aate hain, aapko I think explained enough. Kisi ko abhi bhi samajh nahi aayi to mujhe bata sakte, and then I'll start the questions. Ji, kisi ko samajh nahi aayi ya aayi hai to aap bata sakte hain, just tell me. Is it clear, the passage?
Yes, ma'am, clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what we can do is we will start with the question and answers. First of all, I would like to ask you. Who would like to answer the first question? Why did the writer's father spend time studying the skies? Okay, yes. Why did the writer's father spend time studying the skies? Why did her father do that?
Because of his keen interest.
Yes, because of his keen interest and because of his passion. Now this had actually become his passion, and he would always want to do it. Now see, when something is your passion, is your becomes your habit, you know, you do it and you can't refrain from it, and this had actually become his passion, and he would, and that's why, that was the reason he you know, read the skies. So the answer for the first question is, the writer's father spent his time studying the skies because he had an extreme love for new, unique and ingenious things. He was fascinated by modern scientific devices. So this is a formal answer. Obviously you're going to write it like this. Aap is tarah se ek word ke andar nahi likh sakte ki, for example, jaise bhi somebody answered ki he was interested in that, or it was his keen interest. Iska ye matlab nahi hai ki aapne bas ek line ya do words likh dene hain. You at least have to write 2-3 lines. Acha ji, next. Now depends upon what the question is. Why the writer thinks that there was no need of a barometer? Yes, Dr. Aliab, I think you raise up your hand.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
भावेश शेयर मैम
जी जी
मैम बैरोमीटर इज एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट व्हिच इज यूज्ड टू मेजर द विंड प्रेशर एंड हिज फादर एडेड बैरोमीटर इन हिज डाइनिंग रूम सो देयर इज नो विंड प्रेशर टू मेजर दैट दैट्स व्हाई दैट वाज यूजलेस टू ऐड an instrument like barometer in dining room
maybe it's because it was not needed because it was not yes, needed. Okay just wait for a moment azan break I'll just get back to you azan ke baad just wait for a moment. Okay, yes. So, yes, barometer was actually not needed at that time. Okay. Let's see. Okay. As it was not a thing required at domestic level to be aware of the atmosphere pressure, because us time pe it was not needed. Jaise ki you just replied that it was not required at that moment. Is wajah se it was useless. Okay. What does the bright horizon meant for the writer's father? Yes.
It means that if a person get lost in nowhere, then he can, instead of wandering around, can follow the bright horizon, so he can reach the water, which represent habituation.
And yes, obviously. And where is the bright horizon to be seen,
ma'am? Around the sea, around the river or water.
Okay, but what is the bright horizon? Where does he see the bright horizon?
In the sky.
Yes, on the sky. On the sky. Very good. According to the writer, father's bright horizon signifies the presence of the river, and the bright horizon was actually to be found on the sky. Okay. How did her father influence the river in a later? Sorry, how did her father influence the writer in her later years? Anybody who would like to answer? The writer's meteorological sense got acute in the later years when she started writing stories. Atmosphere had a significant place and influential effect in the story, and obviously her father used to influence everything, you know, to her, and she actually remembered her childhood. Okay, and then her father's influence actually became so strong that, you know, whatever she wrote, whatever the writer wrote in her stories or in her essays, actually had an impact of her father. Even this essay had an impact of her father, because she narrated everything which was related to her father. And this is how the writer had an impact, which she realized in her later years, that yes, her father has a lot of importance, you know, in her life. And this is what I've just told you, that how children are influenced by their parents. Explain the underlying words and phrases in the passage. See, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And there were, I think, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, there were 8. I think, yes, I've written those 8. ठीक है, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. ठीक है, इसका क्वेश्चन आपको मैं एक दफा पढ़ के सुना देती हूँ. एक्सप्लेन द अंडरलाइन वर्ड्स एंड फ्रेजेस इन द पैसेज. बस ये है. ओके, नो नो, इट हैज 8 मार्क्स, सॉरी. ठीक है, आपने इन फ्रेजेस को अच्छी तरह से एक्सप्लेन करना है और इनका मतलब बताना. ठीक है, टू कीप अपॉइंटमेंट्स. ठीक है, जस्ट अ मिनट. यस, ओवर हियर. टू कीप अपॉइंटमेंट्स, व्हाट इज टू कीप अपॉइंटमेंट्स with eclipses? To keep appointments with eclipses. How does a father used to keep appointments with eclipses? Keep appointments ka kya matlab? Kya literal, basically aapne yahan pe sentence ka meaning dekhna hai. Ki kya uska matlab?
I'm always looking to predict weather changes by his instruments.
It's about studying and discovering about the eclipses. Kaleidoscope हमने पहले कर लिया है कि it's an instrument, ठीक है, which has mirrors and colored glass in it, and when the tube is turned, the pieces of the glass actually move and they form different patterns basically. तो reflections से different patterns बनते हैं, जो कि kaleidoscope का एक जो main उसका काम है वो ये है. Assortment of puzzles क्या है? यहाँ पे किस sense में use हुआ?
Different type of instrument that he had.
Different types of basically games ki unhone baat ki, puzzle related games jo yahan pe ki, how to solve those puzzles basically. Assortment of puzzles ye hote ki unko kis tarah se assort karna hai. Theek hai, to take part. To take a part. Basically, यहाँ पे मैंने लिखा हुआ है कि stood apart basically is to change that how you know he used to see things changing. ठीक है, barometer हमने पहले ही कर लिया हुआ है कि it measures pressure. Air pressure. Took a good look.
Ma'am, kindly elaborate to take a part again, please.
Take a part basically है जब यहाँ पे आप इसको इसका आप इसकी जो line पढ़ते हैं ना, for example it says he had also supplied himself with an assortment of puzzles composed of metal rings and intersecting rings and keys, almost childlike love of the ingenuous. In time, a barometer, sorry, I just missed a line. Yes, links and keys chained together, impossible for the rest of us, however, patiently shown to take apart. He had an almost childlike love of the ingenuous. Ingenuous यहाँ पे original है, ठीक है. To take apart, यहाँ पे उन्होंने इस तरह से use किया है कि he used to stood and see how the changes occur. ठीक है, कि how the things were actually occurring, how the changes at that time occurred. ठीक है, took a good look. What is took a good look?
To look at the indicators of weather change.
हाँ जी, took a good look. Took जी जी जी. I can't hear you. Can you please repeat? Okay, it's basically how you observe, your observation. ठीक है, took a good look is to observe in a very keen manner basically. To it's your observation, how well you observe things. ठीक है, मैंने इनके, yes, I've written to keep appointments, kaleidoscope, assortment of puzzles, barometer, take a good look and stood apart. ठीक है, ताकि आप लोगों को कोई कंफ्यूजन ना रहे. ठीक है, और इसके अंदर ठीक है। अच्छा आप मुझे सिर्फ इतना बता दें कि सिंस वी हैव अ क्लास ऑन मंडे ना आफ्टर दिस मंडे को तो हमारी प्रेसी की क्लास है, ट्यूसडे को भी प्रेसी है, देन ऑन वेंसडे वी हैव अ क्लास ऑफ कॉम्पोजिशन अगेन, उसके अंदर आप लोग मुझे कौन सा कॉम्पोजिशन सॉल्व करके ला के देंगे। मैंने जो आप लोगों के लिए सोचा है वो सोचा है 2004 का कॉम्पोजिशन। आप लोग 2004 की कि मैंने आपको प्रेसी भी कही थी और उसी कही आपने कॉम्पोजिशन सॉल्व करना